I went grey in my early 20s, so I have been colouring my hair for the last 20 plus years to not only cover the grey but also because I enjoy fashion colours. Over the years, I've developed this fantastic hair care routine which has made sure that my hair don't break, I don't have hair fall, and most importantly, I don't have the dryness and the frizziness which generally comes when you've been colouring your hair for a very long time. Hi, welcome back. If you're new here, I'm Rubina. I've had a career of 22 years between IT, healthcare and beauty. My hair care routine is very intense and it's also very, very simple. I always make sure that I'm doing the basics right. And what are the basics? The first important thing in basics is to make sure that we treat our hair very, very gently. And it comes down to how do you comb or brush your hair. I'm not very particular about whether I'm using a brush or a wide tooth comb, but my favorite still remains the comb, especially when I have knotted hair, because I can see where the knot is and how can I gently remove the knot. So when you have a knot, go down really easily. In fact, go around the knot. So leave the knotted area aside, go a little lower down below the knot and start working your way upward towards the knot. That way, you are making sure that the knot comes out very easily and does not break your hair. One of the biggest reasons for broken hair or having a lot of flyaway hair or dry hair is when we treat our hair very, very harshly. And this could not only be brushing, this could also be washing our hair. So there is no requirement to rub the hair along each other, you know, when you're washing our hair. I mean, we don't have to go dhobi on our hair really. So, you know, wash it very, very gently. And similarly, comb it down very, very gently. Once my hair is completely detangled, I start with an oil massage. One of my favorite oil massages is to use an onion. An onion, as you know, is very rich in sulfur. In fact, this has also been proven now by a medical study where they did a blind study and saw that using onion actually improves hair growth. I'm going to be sharing the link in the description below. Do have a look. So I use the end of the onion, I dip it in oil and I press it down on my scalp. It's advisable to take onion that's nice and fresh, I mean it shouldn't be too dried out, because then you're able to get a whole lot of juices out of the onion. So I gently massage in the oil as well as keep pressing on the onion with slight pressure so that the juices enter the scalp easily. I make small partings and make sure I have my entire scalp covered with the onion, massaging in the oil. So the sulfur that's found in onions is really, really powerful. It helps replenish the nutrients and nourish the hair follicle very well. It also, I believe, helps in battling premature graying, which I did not know 22 years back. Otherwise, we would have had a different story today. It also adds a beautiful shine to your hair, which I can vouch for. And most importantly, it is antibacterial as well as antifungal, which means you will not have issues like dandruff on your hair at all. It is also great in boosting blood circulation, and if we have great blood circulation in our scalp, we will have nice, long, healthy hair, because the hair follicle which is bathed in nice, nourished blood is always healthier. So I finish my top, I tie up my hair and then go backwards and then go behind my scalp, finish that off. I then open up the top bun and mix the front section as well as the back section together. I of course again re-divide it just so I have better control over my hair. It's especially important when you have long hair. I use the leftover oil at the ends of my hair just to moisture and saturate them. And then I give my scalp a quick 5 to 10 minute massage and then tie it into a loose bun and keep it like this for at least 15-20 minutes. 20 minutes after keeping the oil, I then start with a mask. I start by putting a small hand towel around my shirt. As you'll see ahead in the video, it's a good add-on to have when you're putting a mask. I begin by sectioning out my hair. Now, when you have long hair, it just gets a little unmanageable, especially when you're trying to put a mask. So I like to section it by putting a top knot first, just so I can have better control over my lower section. I tie that out because I'm going to be coming down to it later. And then I open up my top section and divide it into two. I'm going to be doing one section at a time. It just helps you manage the hair better, especially with this mask. The mask that I'm going to be using is a little sticky and also a little runny. So let's get started. This is a banana mask. It's packed with protein and minerals. I'm sure you've heard a version of this mask before and you may have also used it. My version has 2 tablespoons of castor oil, which is great for hair growth, a large egg packed in protein, banana packed with minerals, and curd, which helps maintain your scalp's pH balance, which makes sure you don't have dandruff and itchy scalp. Now this mask can be a little tricky to put, especially because it's watery, but as you get used to putting masks, it gets easier and easier. And I think it's always better to use both your hands just so you're able to part your hair better and in smaller sections. The smaller and thinner your sections, the better you'll be able to reach the scalp and put in the mask evenly out through the entire root section of the hair. After I've done the top scalp area, I then go down and open the lower section and subdivide that again into 2 sections, again just for better manageability. Now I know that the back of my hair is very hard for me to take. Probably I'm not as dexterous as most people are. I take a little bit on my fingers and then massage it in on my entire scalp area behind. I do a lot of masks, but my favorite is of course the banana mask. It improves the shine of your hair and it also prevents dandruff. And it being a natural moisturizer dramatically improves the elasticity of your hair, which means your hair is not so prone to breakage and also it prevents split ends. A shark cap really helps when you're doing an oil massage or a mask because it helps trap the heat inside. And that is always good for the scalp because that helps invigorate the blood supply and make the hair follicle stronger. After about 20-25 minutes, I wash my hair. I generally use very color-specific shampoo and conditioner. It definitely helps in keeping the color for longer and the color doesn't fade very easily or quickly. I'm all set to style my hair. I'm going to be blow-drying my hair at medium heat. This takes me about 20 minutes maximum, but actually about 15 minutes and I'm done. After they are about 80% dry, I then section off the hair, separating the top section from the lower hair. I always tie up my sections, which just helps me manage my hair better. And then I take the lower section, comb out all the knots. I need the hair to be nicely de-knotted and in a flat section so that they curl well. I use these beautiful sponge rollers. They are soft and malleable. You can actually go to sleep with them, and I've done that also. And as you can see, they are very, very easy to use. So I section off half of the lower section hair and go around the roller. It's good to go a little tight so that you get nice bouncy curls. The securing loop needs to go from under the first hair because that will help it secure the hair to the curler. And then I snap on the end to the edge of the curler. The edge of the curler has this nice Velcro bottom, so it's very easy to secure and they're super easy to use. It takes me about 10 to 15 minutes to do my entire head. I really love these curlers because they don't use any heat and therefore it's super simple. I section the head horizontally. You can also do vertically if you want. It doesn't really change the way your curl is going to form. I keep the curlers for about 45 minutes or till the hair is completely dry. And since we've not used heat, the curls are very soft and bouncy, as you can see. I just love these curls and I love the fact that they are so loose and large and bouncy. It gives you this nice romantic, casual, and a very nice feel to your hair. Basically, your hair looks very manageable. As you can see, with this beautiful oil massage and the mask and using a style which doesn't require heat, your hair comes out shiny and soft and they look just beautifully hydrated and moisturized. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please don't forget to subscribe. I post new videos once a week. And do leave a comment on how you found this video and if you'd like to see something else. Till I catch you next time. Bye.